I only have time this evening to share one more big story about synchronicity. If you've been respectfully the kind of person who privately rolls their eyes when someone says, well, you know, things happen for a reason, this big story may provoke you to stop rolling your eyes and perhaps to retask them to begin exploring the story. You'll remember that Carl Jung analyzed 1,300 of Wolfgang Pauli's dreams and visions. In 1934, Pauli described perhaps the most significant recurring dream that he had. It was the dream of a surreal object in motion that he called the world clock. Now, as you can see, the clock consists of four basic components: a horizontal dial upon which four sections are marked with human-like figures holding pendulums, a vertical dial sharing the same central axis. The vertical dial has a large rotating pointer and is divided into 32 sections, a horizontal golden ring surrounding the entire apparatus, and then a large black bird physically supporting the apparatus. The horizontal dial, vertical pointer, and golden ring are all rotating at different speeds, calculated as derivatives of the base number 32, the number of segments on the vertical dial. Okay, now, Victor, I'm really glad you're here, because it's a calculus problem, which I've completely forgotten how to solve. Unfortunately for me, this mathematical signature of the clock was important to a physicist like Wolfgang Pauli, probably important to an engineer too. But mercifully for me and for you, it was the interactive motion signature of the clock that really connects him with Carl Jung, and thankfully allows me to continue my story without the calculus tutorial. The world clock is the most significant inspirational vision of Jung and Pauli's combined model of psychology and physics, the Unus Mundus, the one world. They were continually inspired to discuss and debate the components of the clock for almost 30 years. It was a complicated dialogue, no doubt, naturally fueled by their individual scientific and philosophical passions. But for our purposes, I want to share with you what amounts to their consensus view of the symbolism and the significance of the clock and its connection to the question of synchronicity. At least I'm going to do my best. The large black bird that supports the entire structure is likely symbolic of the known universe or observable space-time, whatever, wherever, and whenever that is. The horizontal dial, with four human figures holding pendulums, represents our conscious existence in earthly time. This real-time existence is consistent with the quantum mechanics principle that local reality is subject to the status of the observer and the observed. In other words, our entire conscious existence is subject to our human measurement of and accounting of time. The vertical dial that shares a common axis with the horizontal dial represents the very separate but interrelated dimension of the collective unconscious. This is the unseen quantum dimension of ancient forms, images, and themes that regularly cycles and intersects with our conscious life. The pointer that emanates from its center moves through the 32 points on the dial at a rate synchronized to the rotation of the horizontal dial. Consequently, when the horizontal dial passes through the vertical dial, at the two points of intersection, you can see them there, at that moment, the position of the pointer dictates what's passed on to our conscious world. These two points of intersection are the perpetual doorways of synchronicity. Now, both Jung and Pauli recognized that the vertical dial was not controlled by man, but was encountered by man at meaningful synchronous moments in our conscious reality. Could be when you're writing a song, Victor. The horizontal golden ring rotates at the same derivative rate as the smaller horizontal dial, but it surrounds the entire clock at a distance and is not itself supported by the black bird. So to Jung and Pauli, the ring suggested a much larger quantum reality that transcends all of our psychic concepts of existence, conscious or unconscious, and physically extends beyond the parameters of the known universe. The golden ring was thought to represent the possible source of the collective unconscious and the underlying principles of the physical universe. It was perhaps the meaning behind the meaning of things. Now, Jung the psychologist was persuaded that the general action of the dials, their correlated spins, and the intersections were a dream vision of the link between the collective unconscious and our conscious world. It was like an elegant picture of synchronicity in action. Pauli, the quantum physicist, agreed with Jung on the issue of psychic synchronicity, but he also saw the clock as a greater image of the synchronous motion and mechanism of the physical universe. Pauli was especially struck by the precise interaction of the horizontal dial and vertical dial, both sharing the same central axis. As a physicist, he was also intrigued by the suggestion in the dream that there was a derivative mathematical relationship governing the movement of all the components. It was, after all, a clock.